apocalypse.
What up, guys? This is your man Klever, and I'm bringing you this awesome PvP troll build video. But before we get into all this mess, I'm gonna be playing the PvP footage from the stream. Definitely stick around if you guys want to see what this build is capable of. This is actually a fight right here, and then there's actually gonna be another fight after that, and then the build video will commence. So you guys just want to go ahead and skip to that, you guys can. If not, definitely stick around and enjoy this build. I did make this, like I said, during my most recent stream. It's really awesome. I made it within 24 hours of that stream, and it just worked great all day. Didn't really fail me much. It's my Running Man build, so if you guys do want to see what I am running, definitely stick around and enjoy.
Hey, watch out, man. Hey, watch out, man.
I didn't even touch your... I didn't even inspect your build. I can see your fucking... the icon of you just being in cover. Or the buff, whatever it is. Why would I look at... why would I look at your shitty skill build?
I bet you.
I made you change your build. Look at it. You changed your build. You're a little bitch.
I inspected it, that's what I'm saying.
I'm your daddy. You're my seed.
I'm ready.
My seed.
Watch out, watch out. You're over there by yourself, bro. You're face tanking by yourself, dude. The meta is back, guys. The shotgun meta is back!
System disrupted.
They're focusing me, bro. Pop a kit. I'm body blocking. Should I do the Running Man build?
Come back out. I got one, no! God, there's just me down. Run Klever, run Klever, no, I bought him time. Arachi and both of them. 1v1 is depends on him. You got one-on-one right now, Klever. The other two are so far behind. You got plenty of time. Everyone get up. Oh my god.
See you later, guys. I hope you guys have your J's on your feet. Dude, they're chasing me like bots. It's funny. I got NPCs behind me, bro. Oh, they don't like that. Stay on their side of the bridge. Do not push bridge. They got cover on their side, bro. Do not push the bridge. Let them come over here. If they want to, they can have this. Should I go buy it off? Should I hit the running man on him? Fuck yeah. I'm over here farming sin. I didn't get kicked out from sin, but they acting like they kicked me out though. Started my own clan, FYI. Get the fuck out my face, bro.
Sit down, bro.
Get the fuck out my face, bro.
Sit down, kid.
Who are you?
Get good at the game, bro.
Who are you, bro? Get out my house.
Didn't even have to fucking use my fiction mention. I had a double team that focused. All three of them focus fired me. Look at that.
Oh, yeah.
Maggots. Hey, I'm gonna take a five. I'm just Hans coming out. Hans, you actually stay?
See you later. What are you doing, bro? You're not gonna push by yourself like that.
Fuck it, retard.
Nice man, huh, bro? Get farmed. You're looking real good on the floor, bro. You guys can hold that L. Ish, what are you doing, bro? Ish, you wasn't ready, Ish. Bye, friend. Healing up.
He thought he had me. Rogue, restore hive. Yeah, I'm gonna foam him. Watch this. Keep eye. Watch this. Foam. I'm still doing 100k crits to the face with no nothing. Where you going, bro? Yeah, popping kit. Oh, no, run, run! What is going on, guys? This is your man KleverThumbs, and I'm back with another Division 2 build video. Now, this is actually going to be the best PvP troll build that I have made for TU9. Now, definitely, guys, are new to this channel, you're gonna wanna stick around, hit that like button, smash the subscribe button, and turn on that notification bell. That way you guys know when I do stream, because this is actually one of the builds that I was using in my recent stream. So definitely stay tuned in. I do a little sneak peeks here and there, give little tips as well that a lot of people don't really know. So let's get right into the build. So like I said, this is my best PvP troll build right here for the Dark Zone. I'm going to jump right into it. I don't want to waste too much of your time. You guys have seen the footage. It is amazing. It works great. This is my Running Man build. So I'm going to tell you exactly how I made this. And I was actually created 24 hours before my recent stream. So let's jump right into this. Now, the specialization that you want to run, or that I want to run, is actually the firewall, and that is for the medkits, the 20% burn duration, and all the other good stuff that it comes with. But let's jump right into the guns. Now I am maining my favorite SMG, which is a tactical vector, 15% SMG damage, 16.5 critical hit chance, and 10% damage to targets out of cover. Now the talents on this bad boy are Optimus. You guys are familiar with this gun. I do use this a lot. I like it. The RPMs are awesome. It feels great in this patch. And it also works great with the talents that I am running. So for my secondary, I am running a Marine Super 90, 15% shotgun damage, 12% damage to armor, and 10% damage to targets out of cover. I believe I actually got this on stream as well that same day, and I upgraded it, and it made just this build so much better. So Optimus is a really good talent. The longer you shoot, the more weapon damage you get. For my backup, you can run whatever you want. I am running a backup boomstick. Let's jump right into this build. Why is this build the best troll build, you'd say? Well, first of all, I have a three-piece golem, which gives you status effect, armor regeneration, and total armor. I have one-piece Gila for the total armor as well. And I'm running the Imperial Holster. You guys are very familiar what this does. And of course, I'm running the Murakami Emperor's Guard knee pads for the armor regeneration. But let's jump right into this build. I do have 1.8 million armor, really good status effects, and high armor regeneration, about 67,000 if played right per second. Let's start off with this mask. Now my mask does have max core attribute of bonus 170k armor, and I do have pretty decent armor regenerations, 3,900, 8% status effects, and 9.6 skill duration, a mod that I did put on there. So let's move on to the chest piece. Like I said, this does give you 10% status effects, 1% armor regen, which 1% of 1.8 million, that's a lot. Believe it or not, that's pretty nice to have. So once I take off, as you guys seen in the video, it's a wrap. It's hard to catch me as I'm healing up constantly. Now for this bad boy, I do have 157k armor, for the core attribute, 10% status effects, and 4,000 armor regeneration per second. Now, I do have the 9.4 skill duration mod on there, and that is for the burn and stuff like that, or whatever skill I'm using. The talents on here that I'm rocking today are unbreakable. This is a really good talent to rock in the PvP, PvE, whatever you want to do. There's better, stronger talents. You guys can Agent run whatever you want. I like unbreakable. Once they think they're about to kill me, boom, I get armor, and then I'm already repairing 67,000 per second, which is pretty nice. So let's move on. You guys are already familiar with the holster. Imperial Dynasty, while in combat, applies burn to the enemy closest to you within 20 meters. They actually did buff this from 40 seconds to 35 seconds. So you guys aren't familiar with what I'm doing here. I do have one skill tier, obviously, that it comes with, and the 8.1 status effects and the 9.2 hazard protection. I can't do nothing about the hazard protection, but it is nice to have because I do have max hazard on my watch, so it's 19% hazard protection right there, which is just decent. You know, it's 20%. I'm gonna dumb something down, but you guys are seeing what I'm getting here with this troll build. Let's move on to the Emperor's Guard. 165k armor, 1% armor regeneration, and 5.4 critical hit chance. This is I wish I could have something better, maybe armor regen or whatever. That's it's decent enough, I guess. Critical hit chance does not hurt this build at all. Now moving on to the last piece of the Golem, which is 170,000 max armor for the core attribute, max armor regeneration, and 9.9 status effects. So you guys are seeing I am stacking a lot into status effect. I forgot to tell you guys that the Murakami does give you 20% skill duration. So as I'm going to move on to the last piece, which is the Gila backpack, the Big Horn backpack. This is Gila. I'm getting 5% total armor, and the core attributes on this are 170,000 armor, max armor regeneration, and 10% status effects. Wow, this is an awesome backpack. I cannot complain about this. I also have 19.5 incoming repairs, so that does help my unbreakable. I get actually 20% on top of my 50%, so I get 70% armor repair when my armor breaks. That is really good. For the talents, you guys are familiar with versatile. I'm just going to read to you the first portion of it, which is what really affects this build the most. Amplifies total weapon damage for 10 seconds when swapping between your primary and secondary weapons if they are different. So 35% to enemies within 15 meters for shotguns and SMGs. Half the time, I am close quarters. Most of the time, I'm always in close quarters because I just like to run into the action. I'll die or not, I'm going to kill, whatever the case may be. I'm the type of guy to be within 15 meters. If not, I don't really worry about the other parts of this talent for the build, like the 35% for the rifles or the marksman rifles or the assaults or LMGs. If you guys do go that route, that is awesome, because sometimes I do run the assault rifle, the Pyromaniac. I forgot to tell you guys that as well. The Pyromaniac is really good for this build because you are putting people on fire. You guys can run the Carnage too if you want. But versatile is really good, gives you amplified damage. So I can swap between my Vector and my Super 90, and I will always have 35% amplified damage as long as I don't overlay them. So there is a small cooldown after you do use it and swap back and forth, so you can't just constantly spam it. But for the skills, this is where it gets really awesome, guys. I really want to share this with you, so let's jump right into this. The Hive. Now, you guys are probably going, wow, this is not much. Your Hive ain't really doing much. Skill tier 1, you know, you got these little things. Okay, well, I'm going to tell you the interesting part. I'm in Defender Zone. You can use the repair skills, which is why I'm saying 67,000. Because 11,000 plus, I'll show you my stats in a second. But let me tell you about this real quick. Let me just give you an idea of what my build is doing. I have a build which is max status effects. I'm squishy, you know, but I have max skill damage, max status effects, and my blinder is doing 23 seconds. That is the max. I've tried to go past max status effects. There's actually a cap to status effect. So the Firefly status effect cap, I believe it's 24, might be 23.9, something like that. Well, if you guys look at my Firefly, I'm actually 11.8. So I'm actually doing half of what a skill tier 6 skill build is doing. If you're investing into 6 skills, excuse me, 6 tier skill build, and you're getting 24 seconds, and I'm only investing into 1 skill tier with max status effects, and I'm getting half of what you would get out of a skill tier 6, this is golden in my opinion. This is freaking awesome. This is what makes this the troll build. I'm running 1 skill tier and I'm getting pretty much like a skill tier, you know, whatever the case may be. I don't know what the base is on the blinder without any mods or skill durations or anything like that, but skill tier 6, half of that is what you got right here. So let's just go with skill tier 3. This is pretty much like having skill tier 3 on here with a tank, and you have versatile as your damage. But enough about the rambling. I know you guys do want to see some stats. I don't have much to show. My vector is only doing 36.954 critical hit damage. That is not enough, but it is enough, actually. Believe it or not, dump a couple magazines into the body and they will retreat, or something's going to happen, because I'm going to have a lot of status effects on you guys. If you guys do have hazard protection, you know, good for you. It's going to help you against this build, but if I start running, I'm just constantly driving a bleed hive. Good luck, man. You're going to have to stop to heal eventually one day while I'm over here with my armor regen. But let's go down to the stats. I do have 1.8 million armor. Like I said, 53,000 armor regen plus my 11k. I forgot to put a couple mods. So it's actually 13k. So it is 63k. No, 66k that I have if I am using the armor regeneration drone, the repair drone. Incoming repairs is 19.5 repairs percent, and the hazard protection, like I said, it's about 20%, so it's nothing too much. I do like this build a lot. It is a really good troll build, you guys have seen in the gameplay. Go ahead, man, make whatever you want of this. This is the build right here for me. You guys want to run all the cheese in the world, I'm gonna put this build, I'm gonna catch a manhunt, and I'm gonna book it and clear it. That's all I gotta say. So this is my best PvP Dark Zone troll build. I hope you guys enjoy this. Definitely stick around for the next video. I will be dropping it pretty soon. I also want to say thank you guys for all my subscribers. You guys are freaking awesome. You guys stick to this channel a lot. You guys are like on this channel like white on rice, so congrats. You guys are freaking amazing. Well, this is your man, Klever Thumbs, and I'm signing out on this one.